What's up, everybody? I'm Noah.
Hey, I'm Josh.
And we're Roman Street. And this Saturday night, our friends at the Velvet Note are going to be restreaming one of our performances at thevelvetnote.com.
Yeah, y'all go check it out tomorrow night at 7:30 Eastern. We love Tamara and everyone there at the Velvet Note. They've been so good to us over the years. And so y'all go check it out. There is going to be a donate link where you can donate to the Velvet Note and kind of help keep them going during all of this. And we appreciate you guys so much. They're also going to have a link to purchase our new album, Balcony of the World, that we released a couple months ago. So y'all go check it out tomorrow night, 7:30 Eastern.
Check it out. Appreciate you guys.
The Velvet Note's a place where you can see and hear world-class musicians in a setting that's as intimate and as comfortable as your very own living room. What we try to do here is bring down the wall that often exists between artists and audiences. We give you a chance to get to know the artist. You're always guaranteed a chance to meet the artist. And we also want you to hear the music the way that it was meant to be heard. We have the best jazz performers in the world who perform here. Grammy winners, people who are legends in the jazz field. And all you have to do is go right down the street. Here, you're able to see them, and they're right in front of you. They're an arm's length away from you. It's like they're performing a private concert for you and the people you love. It's a once-in-a-lifetime experience.
Hi, I'm Carla Harris. As a performer and as a listener who has enjoyed some incredible shows at the Velvet Note over the years, I've often been struck by how when people are inside those walls, the issues of the world outside just fall away, and the connection between everyone inside is heightened. To me, that is the power and the magic and the beauty of the live music experience. And it's why I hope that as you enjoy the encore concerts that the Velvet Note is streaming each weekend, that if you are able, that you would click the donate button that you see somewhere on your screen, because when you do, you'll help the Velvet Note make it through this tough time and be there when we can gather again and feel that magic. So thanks for helping Tamara keep the stage lights and the twinkle lights on. Thank you. And I hope you enjoy the music.
All we need is love and music. And a little chocolate now and then doesn't hurt. Please help us bring these performances into your home without charging a fee. Donate at thevelvetnote.com. Donate. Since 2006, brothers Noah and Josh Thompson have put their guitars together to form Roman Street. What started as a friendly jam session has developed into the Billboard iTunes charting band, who many have dubbed the next generation of jazz fusion. Roman Street is an internationally trained instrumental band specializing in improvisational fusion of classical, gypsy, and contemporary jazz, Latin, and Nuevo Flamenco. A departure from the overproduced music that is out there today, they keep it simple. The beautiful organic sound of acoustic instruments played by talented people who love what they're doing. The name Roman Street came from an old Roman street in the Alps where the Thompson brothers studied guitar. The band has opened concerts and festivals for international sensations George Benson, the Gypsy Kings, Ziggy Marley, Boney James, Dave Koz, The Rippingtons, Earl Clue, Jesse Cook, Foreplay, Maroon 5, Michael McDonald, Bella Fleck, and the Preservation Hall Jazz Band. They've also received international airplay on over 200 stations, including Sirius XM Watercolor Satellite Radio and Music Choice Cable TV. Whether they're performing as a guitar duo or with a backing band with notable rhythm section brothers Joseph and Bryan Morris, Roman Street astounds with music that appeals to fans of many genres.
Thank you. How are we doing this evening?
Good.
Everybody good?
Yeah.
Man, it's packed in here. Yeah. We love you for it, too. So we're thrilled to be back here in Alpharetta. This is still by far and away one of our favorite places to play, and I'll tell you guys why when we're playing, because you can literally hear every note, everything I play, everything I imagine, you know, 10 seconds before I play it, you can hear it in here, and I love that. And we're going to start off, our show's a little bit different tonight. I mean, I know we have a lot of familiar faces tonight, so thank you guys for coming back. Those of you that are new, enjoy yourselves, thank you for coming. We'll tell you a little bit about us here in the set, but we'll go ahead and get started with one of our original songs. This one's called Cubana.
Yeah. y'all so much.
Well done. Thank you very much.
Good to see you.
So Josh and I have been really just blessed to be able to play with these two guys for a number of years. They're also brothers, by the way, if you guys didn't notice.
It's true.
Joe Morris on the bass guitar, Bryan Morris on the drums, both from Mobile, Alabama. They come from a musical family, the Morris family here in Mobile, Alabama, and been playing music in our city for decades and generations. And so on our Bohemia album back in 2016, we were working up a song in the studio and decided to name it after them in honor of their family. Family's musical history is called Mr. Morris. We want to play that one with you now.
So,
We're having a little brother discussion up here. Brian decided to play. That's really what's happening.
That was our democratic process, right?
Yeah, now. It just happened. So we're working on a new album. We're gonna have it out in the next few months. I think by March we're gonna have a new CD.
We're almost done.
Yeah, isn't that awesome?
We won't be done, but we decided to record two more songs last Tuesday, and we thought it might be fun just to play them tonight.
Yeah, why not? Yeah.
So you guys will be the first people to ever hear these songs, you know. Part of our history, really, it's true. Well, I mean, the engineer in the studio, he heard it like a bazillion times. But yeah, we got to check out three new songs. You want to talk about yours?
We're just playing all
three. Yeah, let's play all three. Which is like a little preview of the new CD, if you will.
Let's do this first.
Okay. All right, so I got two new songs. These are the two that we recorded last Tuesday. The first one is called Rosemary Beach. You guys ever been to Rosemary Beach? Go on now. I know y'all. Atlanta always seems to be well represented down there. But Josh and I have been going down to Rosemary Beach in 38 for years and playing music. And we actually have a song off of our first album called 38. But we were really technically in Rosemary Beach. We were the festival that brought us down there to play. Got us one of those little houses, and we were sat on the front porch and had some coffee. And I came up with that song, and it's just a beautiful place. I mean, you guys know. Anyway, so I had a little jazzy song, and it kind of reminded me of being down there playing at the farmers markets years ago in Rosemary. And so here's a new tune for you called Rosemary Beach. Thank you. guys very much. This is currently my favorite new song. Internally, we've been calling it 2.0. See what you guys think. Ready? This is for you, Tamara, wherever you are.
I'm right here, though.
There you go. Thank you. Thank you.
Alright, well, so we're going to do another one, a new one for you guys. This is definitely much more on the Latin side for sure. This is one of my new ones, and I haven't named this one yet. I usually wait until kind of the end until we get done with recording, which we just did, to name a song. So I'm actually going to ask y'all's help on this one. We're going to play this next one for you guys. And afterwards, if y'all, I don't know, if you feel inspired, if y'all hear a name or something, y'all just come find me afterwards, or one of us. And we actually did this in the first show. We got some pretty good names.
First show, that's a
good
suggestion.
We got some pretty good ones.
Saying.
So
no pressure.
Yeah. So yeah.
Some of them were love at first sight.
Oh, I have some of them were.
Somebody wanted us to call it the Velvet Note. I think that one's good. Tamara spoke that down with copyright infringement, though.
Well, this is just enough Latin for you.
Just enough Latin for you.
So yeah, anyway, yeah, I have not named this one yet. So yeah, we're going to play this next one for you guys now. See what you think. Thank you. Anybody got any good ideas? I can't see any of you, but you know.
What was the name? Somebody's got the name. I heard it.
We have a name.
Yep. Okay. I'm ready.
And
yeah, listen, this is the Latin table here.
Okay.
So you have Dominicans, Puerto Ricans, Colombians.
Fantastic.
All right. Hell yeah.
So
bienvenidos.
The minute you started, I said I got the name.
He did.
So it's Sabor.
Sabor.
All right.
That's awesome.
I like it.
We have a percussionist that we work with sometimes from Havana, and he always screams Sabor at me and Josh when we're playing. He's like, for gringos, you guys have Sabor, for real.
That's what we were talking about.
And always say, "Si." Hey, thank you guys very much, Sabor.
I like that name.
That's a good one, Sabor. Thank you guys, man. Appreciate you sharing that.
Anybody like Gypsy Kings here?
Yeah! This is from my Latin table, guys. Yeah, my Puerto Ricans, my Dominicans, my Colombians. Thank you guys very much. We hope you like this one. This is called Bamboleo. Y'all help me sing it.
Thank you.
that.
We do.
Alright. Something you want to slow it down a little bit? Play something romantic. Everybody got some wine?
We're gonna do this is one of my favorite songs of all time. It's called Besame Mucho. Anybody love that song like I do? Anybody know it? It's just one of the most beautiful pieces of music ever, and we learned it probably 5 or 6 years ago, and we play it pretty much every show now, and I love it every single time, so here we go, Besame Mucho. Thank you.
So yeah, this next one, this next one is one of my favorite songs of ours. It always has been. It's probably one of my earliest compositions, actually. Took a trip down to St. Lucia years ago, and ended up sitting in with the hotel band, you know, this band that played in the lobby every night. It was a four-piece. And they just groove so hard, man. I love those guys. They had that nice kind of Caribbean Latin feel to them. And of course, I had to go up there and bribe the guitar player with some, I don't even remember, money or drinks or something to let me get my hands on that guitar for a few minutes. And anyway, so I came up with this tune and ended up, for lack of a better idea, I just called it Santa Lucia after the island there in St. Lucia. It was our first radio single years ago, and we heard it on the way up here yesterday. One of our best charting songs. I hope you guys like it. See what you think. We'll be right back. This is why I love the Velvet Night right here.
It's a place where you can see and hear world-class musicians in a setting that's as intimate and as comfortable as your very own living room. What we try to do here is bring down the wall that often exists between artists and audiences. We give you a chance to get to know the artist. You're always guaranteed a chance to meet the artist. And we also want you to hear the music the way that it was meant to be heard. We have the best jazz performers in the world who perform here. Grammy winners, people who are legends in the jazz field. And all you have to do is go right down the street. Here, you're able to see them and they're right in front of you. They're an arm's length away from you. It's like they're performing a private concert for you and the people you love. It's a once-in-a-lifetime experience. All we need is love and music and a little chocolate now and then doesn't hurt. Please help us bring these performances into your home without charging a fee. Donate at thevelvetnote.com.
Thank you guys very much. Does anybody have any questions or comments?
Concerns?
Complaints?
Advice?
Amazing.
Anything at all?
Say what?
Amazing.
Oh, thank you. Appreciate it. Thank you.
Thank you. Hold on.
You're so welcome.
Thank you.
Thank you to Mr. Roberts. Because of him, I discovered you guys.
Awesome. Mr. Roberts.
Thank you.
On the way here tonight, Jose said, we'll try not to embarrass you. Oh, no. I said, go for it. You guys are great.
Oh, that's awesome. Thank you, Jim. Jim and Tatiana are some of our biggest supporters, and we love them very much. Thank you so much for the support. So, Josh and I, when we first started playing out, you know, it's just the two of us. And we composed a lot of songs that way over the years. And You know, we try to, at least every show, to sit down and play a song, just the two of us, like it used to be back in the day. And this next one is one we don't play out very often. I can't remember if we played it here or not. Probably not, because we kind of put it on the shelf for a long time. With the exception of, you know, one of the cool things about being a musician that I never really anticipated whenever I signed up for this kind of life was when you compose a song and you just compose it for yourself and you share it with your brother and y'all make a nice song out of it and you record it and you send it out into the world, you never really know how it's going to hit people or what they're going to think and, you know, part of the creative process, right? So we started getting some inquiries back from these brides that were getting married and they loved the song and they wanted us to play this song for them as they walked down the aisle to get married. Wow. And that just struck me in such a great way. I mean, I just... You know, Josh and I played a lot of wedding ceremonies, and it's just such a beautiful moment in so many people's lives that somebody would want our song as part of that was pretty moving. And so we decided to kind of bring this one back out in our live shows too, and see what you guys think about it. It's called Hope. Thank you. Thank you, guys. Thank you. Thank you.
Motown fans? Because our mother, both of our parents actually are huge Motown fans, and we grew up listening to it all the time. And this is one of our personal favorites. We picked it up this year. It's a song by the Spinners called I'll Be Around. We can sing so bad.
I try. I come over here in my corner and I sing to myself.
And, I just start singing and push the mic as far away as I can.
I'm trying to blow anybody off here. So really, no questions. Anybody? Everybody good? Everybody having a good time?
Awesome.
So we have a few special people here tonight. They know who they are. They have come to see us many times. We love them very much. And I happen to know they have favorite songs. And if I don't get to all of you, I'm sorry. I know we're running late, but y'all hang out with us. I'm going to play some music for you. This is one for the lady on the couch. See if she likes it.
Oh,
Geneva Romance. And, yeah. So from my lovely lady right here in the front, she, I'm almost positive you love this song. I hope you do. Otherwise, my memory is totally leaving me for a long time. This is one that Josh and I learned over in Europe years ago. One of the first songs we learned over there. It's a great gypsy song called Dark Eyes. We hope you guys like it. Carry on.
Sorry.
We'll be right back.
Noah playing the drums right behind me. My favorite drummer is playing the drums. My good friend, Mr. Bryan Morris. Maybe one more song, yeah?
Yeah!
One more song, yeah?
Three
more. So we're gonna go straight Latin on this one. We've done some Gypsy, we've done some smooth jazz, we've done some Latin jazz.
We did
jazz.
Some Korean Clearwater Revival.
We did.
Threw that in there for like 10 seconds. Yeah. This one is the You Stop That. You Stop That.
Just so y'all know I'm from Alabama, for real.
We all are.
Oh yeah.
This is true. Do what? Yeah, this is one of our favorite ones called Strum. Hope you like it.
Thank you.